In this video, I'll show you how to create this camera zoom effect by switching between two cameras when you click on one of the menu buttons. You could also use a similar method to just change one camera position on button click. First, you will need to create your menu widget if you haven't already. I will link a great, in-depth tutorial in the description on how to create menu screens. Next, create two camera actors and place them in your scene. You can do this by moving around your scene until you find the angle you like, then click this drop-down menu and select Create Camera here and then Camera Actor. For this example, I created two level sequences by selecting Cinematics, then Add Level Sequence. The first sequence I made pans the first camera when the menu is initially loaded. To do this, click Track, then search for your camera actor. My camera actor is already added to this sequence. You can click Track on the camera actor and find Transform if it is not already there. Add keyframes by clicking plus or hitting enter on your keyboard. Once you're happy with it, press Save. I do the same thing again for the laptop zoom sequence with the second camera. For both sequences, make sure to check that Keep State is selected for when finished under Properties. Next, you'll want to create a new game mode for your menu. Game modes define the rules of your game. They outline the fundamentals, for example, like the number of players required to play. It is common to create a game mode for each level of your game. The code to play the zoom sequence will live here. Since you can't reference the level blueprint inside your widget code, meaning you won't be able to reference your camera actors directly here, you will use the game mode to create a function for the zoom sequence or whatever your camera switch is. The basic idea for what I'm about to show you is that inside your widget, the onClicked event will call the camera switch function from your game mode. The game mode, however, still can't reference the second camera directly, as we need the level blueprint for that. So we will create a variable called camera, then assign or set this variable to the desired camera actor inside the level blueprint. The function I created looks like this, where I dragged the camera variable and selected get, then set view target with blend. Created level sequence player and selected my laptop close-up sequence, then called play. After each piece of code you write, don't forget to hit compile and save. Next, go to your menu widget, select the button you wish to switch cameras with, and scroll down until you see onClicked. You will want to cast to your new game mode, drag out object, and search for get game mode. How casting works is that you are trying to access the functions or variables inside a blueprint that you would normally not have access to. This block essentially asks, are you the object I'm calling out for? In this case, are you a game mode? If the answer is yes, then we can access all the functions and variables inside of that game mode. If not, the cast failed, and here you could print on the screen cast failed if you're debugging your code. When successful, the key to access all those things inside the game mode are now available by dragging out as main menu game mode. In this case, we want to use that camera switching function we made, so we search for that. Now all that's left is to write out level blueprint code and pass the camera reference over to the game mode. Open your level blueprint. In this case, I want the first camera sequence to play immediately. Then I create the menu widget so it will show up on the screen by adding it to the viewport. This fade widget is an irrelevant effect I added on. You can ignore this. Now here is where we reference our camera for the game mode. When the cast is successful, we can access our camera variable inside the game mode and assign it the camera reference. Once all that is set up, you will need to make sure this level is set to the proper game mode for it to work. Go to Window, then World Settings, and change the game mode override to your new game mode. And that's it. Hopefully you found this tutorial helpful. There are always so many ways to achieve camera switching, so if you know of another method, or have feedback on how to improve this method, please feel free to share it in the comments to help out others.